It is time for quick Om chanting. Take a comfortable position. Keep your backbone straight. Brahmanad. Swasth.
Hello students. Last class we had a thorough discussion on the basis of animal classification. Classification of animal kingdom. What are the basis? Yes. The level of organization, the symmetry, body plan, germ layers, siloam, segmentation or metamerism, not occur. So let us make a quick recap. Discuss some questions. What are the types of siloam? Siloam, body cavity. What are the types of siloam? Yes, siloam is of two types. Okay, that may be schizocoelic siloam and enterocoelic siloam. Enterocoelic siloam. As we have discussed in the last session, the schizocoelic. When or schizo, people are saying schizo or schizo. Okay, schizocoelic siloam, when it is formed by the splitting of mesodermal within the mesodermal mass, due to the splitting of cells, a space is created, cavity is created, schizocoelic. And enterocoelic siloam, when the siloam is formed due to outgrowth on Canthenon. Is it? Yes. Next. On the basis of siloam, nematelminthes are. Do they have true siloam? No. So, what are they? They are called pseudo siloam. What are they called? Pseudo means false. Pseudo silomates. Animals are called pseudo silomates. Next question. The phenomenon is the process. The phenomenon in which the animal body is divided into series of segments both externally and internally in a repeating manner is called, the phenomenon is called, yes, metamerism. Metamerism. Okay, next. A rod-like structure derived from mesoderm. Mesoderm, ectoderm, endoderm, mesoderm, they are the germ layers. They are developed, produced in embryonic stage. Yes, mesoderm. Formed on the dorsal side. Dorsal side, this side. Ventral side, this front side. On this side, our belly, that abdomen, udaradesha. Abdomen is there. That side is called ventral. And on this side, the backbone. Here our backbone is here. Backbone is present. The back side is called dorsal side. What are the lateral side? Yes. Hands are present on the lateral side. Okay, this is right lateral, this is left lateral. Okay, and head is present towards anterior. And we don't have the tail. Animals, those who are having, just imagine the tail on this side, it is present, that is the posterior side. I mean, the abdomen is going. Okay, So on the dorsal side, again I am repeating the question, a rod like structure derived from medulla formed on the dorsal side during embryonic development in some animals is called, what is that called? Called? Yes, notochord. It is called notochord. You know, you were used to tell notochord in Odia, Prustaroju. And okay, the structure is called rod-like structure is called notochord. And the animals are known as, what are the animals are known as, those who are having the notochord? Yes, they are chordates. Animals are called chordates. On the basis of germ layers, plantish and winters, that means plant worms, are called, yes, on the basis of germ layer. How many germ layers are present? These are triploblasts. Triploblastic animals or triploblasts. Three germ layers. Present so triploblasts. Okay. Are you excited for today's topic? Yes, today's topic is the outline classification of animal kingdom. On the basis of these characteristics that we have discussed, the basis of classification of animalia or animal kingdom. Okay. Let us discuss the outline classification of kingdom animalia. Then we will discuss the characteristics of non-chordates, that means invertebrates. Okay, write down the questions, question and answers. Kingdom animalia. Which kingdom? Yes, kingdom animalia. Animalia, on the basis of level of organization, on the basis of level of organization, it can be of two types. What are they? It can be of two types. Cellular level of organization or tissue, or that tissue level, organ system level of organization. Cellular level. Or what? It may be tissue or organ system level. Of organization. Now, cellular level. Do the porifera belongs to cellular level? Do they have cementing? No cementing. Do they have body cavity? No. The phylum is known as porifera. So, straight we will take up to the porifera, up to the phylum. That is phylum porifera. Classification, the symmetry they are not showing, they are not having the shilum, and they do not possess any metamerism or segmentation, they do not possess any segment, they do not show segmentation. So these are generally called the parajva, because you just recall the all animals are called metajva. We discussed the term. What is that? The term animalia means we can tell all animals are called metajva. All animals called metazoa. Whereas the coelophera, because they are separated from other such groups, they do not contain and they do not have any tissue, do not form the organ or organ system. So they are called the parazoa. Para means silent. They are kept in one side. So they are separated and they are kept from the main group. So they are called parajua. Para means silent. Joa means animal. What do you mean by para? Para means side, beside. Joa means animals. Okay, and these are called eumetazoa. They form the tissue, they show symmetry, have the body cavity. Okay, these are called eumetazoa. Eumetazoa means, eu means grow, metazoa means mature, higher animals. Eu means true. Meta means a little higher level. Okay? Higher level. These are low grade. Coelophorans are low grade animals. So, high level organisms. Higher animals. Maybe invertebrate or higher, simply you will tell higher. Meta means higher level. Joa means animal. Okay. Now, next is symmetry. These organisms, those who are showing the tissue or organ or organ system level, they are of different kind. Like they may be radial or they may be bilateral. The symmetry may be radial symmetry or the bilateral symmetry. Radial or bilateral. Now see, if they are having the radial symmetry, and which animals? Yes, the coelenterates. Coelenterates are divided into cnidarians and ctenophores. That we will discuss when we will discuss the characteristic of the each phylum. So, radial symmetry required which phylum? Which animal show the radial symmetry? Yes, the animals showing radial symmetry, they are the cnidarians and ctenophores. Cnidarians means they are kind of coming into coelenterates. And the ctenophores are also coelenterates. May be cnidarians or they may be ctenophores, and actually they are grouped into two phyla, that's why cnidarians and ctenophores, or simply cnidaria. Animals are called cnidarians. Ctenophora. Animals are called ctenophores. So we are discussing the phylum Pinophora. Okay, so these are the radial symmetry. They can be cut into two halves, at least by more than two in two planes. Then bilateral symmetry. The animals, those who are showing the bilateral, only one plane that divides the body into two symmetrical or identical halves. This is bilateral symmetry. Those who are showing bilateral symmetry, they may have the coelom or without coelom. They may be acoelomate on the basis of coelom. Body can give coelom. Acoelomate, pseudocoelomates, pseudocoelomates, or the true coelomates of coelomates. Coelomates means having the true coelom, having the true body cavity. Okay. So they may be coelomates. That means without coelom. Without coelom, they are pseudocoelomates. Means with false coelom. With false coelom. And coelomates means having the true body cavity with coelom. True coelom. You can write down with the true coelom. With the true coelom of our body cavity. True coelom of body cavity. So, what are the acoelomates? Acoelomates, they are the platyhelminthes. They are the platyhelminthes. And what are the pseudocoelomates? They are nemahelminthes. Acoelomates are platyhelminthes. 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 What are the pseudocoelomates? Pseudocoelomates are nothing but the nemahelminthes or nematodes. Nemahelminthes. See, platyhelminthes. Helminthes means worm. Platy means flat. Nematohelminthes. Nemato means round. Platy means? Yes. What is platy? Platy, what will this do? Platy means flat. Helminthes means worm. Okay. Helminthes means worms. However, nemahelminthes are also known as nematoda. What are they known as? Nematoda. Round worms. Generally known as round worms. Okay. Then the coelomates are annelids, arthropods, molluscs. Mollusca, echinodermata, hemichordata, and chordata. What are they? Annelida, arthropoda, mollusca, echinodermata, okay, Annelida, arthropoda, mollusca, echinodermata, hemichordata, hemichordata, and chordata. These are the different phyla. There are 10 phyla. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Coelenterides taken as one. If you are counting it as Cnidaria and Pinophora, then you will get 11. Okay. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Ask to help nematodes, as I also know that nematoda, also known as ask to help in this. Ask. ASC, helmin test, ask helmin test. Ask helmin test. These are the synonyms of nematelmin test. Nematoda, nematelmin test, ask helmin test. Okay, so the classification of the animal, the science of classification. Of organism is called taxonomy. Already the science of classification of organism is known as taxonomy. Science of classification. Science of classification of organisms. Is called taxonomy. Already we have discussed taxonomy. Is it? The arranging the living organisms. Here what we do? The arrangement of organism into different groups. What we do, arrangement of, here animals, so arrangement of living organisms, O-R-G-N, if we write, that means for the organism, of living organism, into different groups. So, what are the different groups? First we will that into different phyla, that kingdom, the seven levels, the kingdom, the phylum, kingdom, phylum, class, order, family, genus, species. These are the seven ranks or levels of classification. And here we have up to the phylum. In your class 11, the characteristics of the phylum. So we will discuss about phylum. Note down the points. Okay. Then we will discuss the how the animal kingdom is classified on the basis of whether they are having notochord or not having notochord. Okay. The classification of kingdom Animalia into non-chordata and chordata on the basis of the presence or absence of notochord. On the basis of presence or absence of notochord. As already we discussed the non-chordata, the porifera, cylindrata. Porifera, the sponges generally the called sponges. Okay, so some examples we will discuss the sponges, siphon, cylindrata. They are the example we can take the hydra. The cylindrata it will divided into nidaria and pinocera. Pinocera actually comes under minor phyla. What is minor phyla? I will make you understand. Cylindrata example. Here I am giving the examples. Okay. See, here I am writing the examples of different phyla. Example animals. Okay, so the phylum means singular, phyla means plural. Here the name of the phyla means plural. Okay, so the platyhelminthes, Its blood on ciliate terata means those who are having a anterior nerve cavity. And like a helmet face, these are platforms. Platforms, you can liver fluke. Example, liver fluke. Fasciola, fasciola hepatica. Jakrutakrumi, you are saying. Liver fluke. Fasciola, scientific name is fasciola. Hepatica. Hepatica related to liver. Okay. Nemma helminthes, ass helminthes, nematoda. These are round worms. Generally known as, commonly called round worms. Example, hilarial worm, or we can say the ascaris. Ascaris. Filarial worm. Which causes the filaria? Filarial worm. Anelida. The common example is earthworm. Anelida. Earthworm. Arthropoda. The insects comes under. The insects come under arthropoda. For example, the cockroach. Okay, the ant, many, the even you can say prawn, you eat prawn, mollusca, snail, example is, we can take snail, snails, echinodermata, starfish, Hemichordata, Balanoglossus. Balanoglossus. Okay, you know that Hemichordata, previously it was thought that the some part of the body consists of notochord, but actually it is concluded that it is not containing any notochord, it is only the hard, little hard part. It is not notochord. Notochord, if it is not present, they are coming under the non-chordata, or they are also known as infarctate. Infarctate, non-chordata is the name of the sub-kingdom. Then under that non-chordata sub-kingdom, kingdom is in the lung. Under that sub-kingdom, non-chordata. Under that, these are the phyla. The non-chordates are also known as invertebrates. Also known as invertebrates. Okay. The minor phyla. Actually, when the one group is divided into two groups due to the evolution, at that time some remain, some reflect both the characters, some remain, they are very minute, they are very small in size, right on what I am saying, am I right? Okay, these are very minor, it's very small, minute, which cannot be seen with the naked eye. We need the microscope, and they are put under the minor. They are taken as minor phyla. So phyla means plural, minor phyla, number of minor phyla are there. You see, when ciliated, from ciliated, it is taken, one is nidaria. Nidaria. Example is hydra. Okay, it's the nidaria, example is hydra. Again, another is Tinophora. Tinophora is taught over here as a phyla. Actually, it is a minor phyla. Others are major phyla. Large number of organisms are there. Variety, diversified. A huge number of organisms, diversified organisms are there. Small to large. So, Tinophora also coming under minor phyla. So these are the invertebrates. Then come to the quadrata groups who are having the notochord. This classification is on the basis of presence or absence, notochord. The rod-like structure present in the dorsal side. Okay, quadrata. A craniata, craniata. Craniata, cranium means brain box. What I am writing, you write down. Cranium means brain box. Our brain is present in the bony box, skull. So, brain box. From that word, it is craniata, A craniata. Those who are having brain box, craniata. Those who are not having A, craniata. Without brain box. Okay? Is that clear? Okay. A craniata, again, cephalopodrata, uropodrata. Because these are podrata. Notochord is present in the cephalopodrata. Cephalic region, at the head region. Uropodrata, notochord present in the tail part. Okay? When it is present in the tail part. Notochord present in tail part. Your cephalon. Cephalon means head. Okay. The example is amphioxus. Amphioxus is the example of cephalopodrata. Uropodrata example is headmania. Now come to the craniata. Craniata may be gnathostomata and agnatha. Jaw. This is lower jaw. This is upper jaw. Lower jaw having the teeth. Upper jaw also having the teeth. The jaw, okay, jaw bones, okay, the jaw, if it is present, jaw bone, gnathostomata, this is, if it is present, then gnathostomata, if it is not present, agnatha, without jaw, okay, so these are the subphylum, craniate, craniate group under the phylum quadrata, then under that group, two subphylum, agnatha and gnathostomata. Under the agnatha, the class is cyclostomata. Below the phyla, the main level is class. So, in between this group and subphyla, other. So, class is cyclostomata. Example is pteromyzen. P remains silent. How you will pronounce? Pteromyzen. Okay, pteromyzen. Then, gnathostomata, Pisces. All pieces coming under that. Pisces. And the tetrapoda, chatuspada brand, okay, in Odia. These are Pisces and tetrapoda are the two superclass under the subphylum Gnathostomata. Mouth is surrounded Gnatho and stomata. I am writing the meaning of here. Gnathos, Gnatho is jaw, stomata means mouth. Stomata means mouth. Mouth is surrounded by jaws. Jaws, okay, jaw are present surrounding the mouth. And the Pisces are mainly four types. They are undrichthyes, holocephali, osteichthyes, and diploid. These are undrichthyes, which also known as elasmobranchia. What they are known as? Elasmobranchi. Elasmobranchi, example scoliodon or dogfish, commonly known as dogfish. Okay, holocephali, they are the variety of chondrichthyes. Chondrichthyes, they are having the cartilage. They are skeleton, endoskeleton. What skeleton we are having? Endoskeleton, internal skeleton, kankara. That, the cartilage, bone is osti, cartilage, upasti. I think so. Okay. So, chondrichthyes, whose endo-internal skeleton is made up of cartilage. Holocephali, their skeleton is also made up of cartilage. Osteichthyes, bony pieces. For example, rohu. Also, osteichthyes are also known as teleostomy. But they are known as teleostomy. Diploid. They are also the bony pieces. But some characters like chondrichthyes. We will discuss in detail the example is Protopterus. Okay, now tetrapoda are divided into tetrapoda is the superclass under the subphylum Nathustomata. Tetra means four, poda means leg. Tetra means four, poda means legs or feet. Your legs or limbs, legs or we can say limbs, limb, L-I-M-B, limbs.
We are having four legs to four limbs. The two limbs are hand, two limbs are leg. We are having.
So tetrapoda are four divided into four. What are these classes? What are these classes? Amphibia, reptilia, apes, and mammalia. Amphibia, frog, toad. Okay, frog, toad. Reptilia, snakes, lizard. Apes means all birds. Mammalia, rat, rabbit, man, human being.
The mammalia.
Okay. Note all these points, we'll do the classification. See, again I am repeating, non-coated code on the basis of the presence or absence of the notochord. Okay, where from this the vertebral column is formed in cortex, in vertebrates, in, not in vertebrate, in vertebrata, in the animals are vertebrata. Okay, non-chordata and chordata. If the notochord is absent, then non-chordata. If the notochord is present, then they are chordata. Notochord is developed during the embryonic stage. Bhruna avastha, during the embryonic stage. So, chordata again, on the basis of whether the brain box, skull, if it is present, brain, our brain is soft tissue, very soft. Okay, to be protected, it needs a hard box. So, if the box is present, bony box, okay, or cartilaginous box, cartilaginous cartilage, made up of cartilage. Okay, so craniatum is brain box. Craniatum is anywhere those who are having brain box. So, craniatum is brain box. If present, if brain box is present, here what is? What happened? Brain box is present. Your brain A means without. Brain box is absent, not present. Okay? Those who are not having the brain box, simply brain is there for brain box. Again, cephalochordata, neurochordata. Cephalo means head region. Euro means tail region. Tail region. In the tail region, notochord is present. In the head region, the notochord is present. Okay? So, and the craniate are also known as vertebrata. Because in craniate animals, the notochord becomes vertebral column. But in a craniate, in cephalochordata and uropodata, notochord remains as notochord. Notochord is not converted into vertebral column, not converted into vertebral column. So vertebrata, they are notochord when they take birth, when they grow adult, notochord develops into vertebral column, backbone. And they are divided into Gnathostomata and Agnatha. Agnatha, no jaw, round mouth. They are in cyclostomata. Cyclo means round. Circular, stomata means mouth. Cyclo means circular. Stomata means mouth. Okay? So which are the animals which are having the round mouth and always remains open. Okay? So cyclostomata and Gnathostomata, again they are divided into two superclass, Pisces and Tetrapoda. Pisces, the fishes. Pisces means all fishes. The scientific the taxon, name of the taxon is Pisces superclass. Superclass, again two superclass are there under the Gnathostomata, that's why Pisces, Tetrapoda, these are the taxon, name of, scientific name of any taxonomic unit is called, any category is called taxon. Show here, these are the two taxon. And Pisces again, chondrichthyes, holocephali, linguistic thighs, diplodocus, tetrapoda, amphibia, reptilia, except mammalia. Now, let us discuss the characteristic of non-prograde, non-cortex or non-prograde. Characteristics of non-prograde, this is a sub-kingdom of other, the kingdom Animalia. As we discuss, this way, directly pulled from the prograde phylum, actually we can say non-prograde and prograde. Chordata and Chordata, these are the two sub-kingdom. Under the Chordata sub-kingdom, these are the sub-kingdom. And under the sub-kingdom, Chordata again Chordata phylum, Chordata phylum. But under the non-Chordata, there are number of phyla, as we discussed. This is the subkingdom of Animalia. Notochordi is absent. Includes all non-chordates or invertebrates. Animals are called non-chordates or invertebrates because no notochord, no vertebral column. Completely vertebral column is absent. Non-chordate is double, ventral, solid, and ganglionated. We have to understand this point. You see, this is called neuron. Neuron, you see, neuron. What you tell neuron? This is the neuron. North cell or neuron or north cell. Okay? When I will show you this in a rock diagram. Suppose this is the this is the cell, this is called cytome and this is called axon and these are dendrites. These are called dendrites. Okay, remember this much. So now, so this is, suppose this is the, this is the neuron. If number of neurons, number of cytons, number of axon, okay, are there, then when number of cyton, mass of cyton, mass of cyton is called ganglion. What it is called? Ganglion in the invertebrate body. So, if the north cord, we are having the north cord inside our vertebral column. Inside the vertebral column, north cord is there, which is called Susumna khanda, the spinal cord. Okay. Here in invertebrate, simply it is known as north cord, which is called spinal cord because it is present inside the vertebral spinal bone. Spinal bone, backbone, vertebral column. Okay. So this is the cyton, mass of cyton equal to ganglion. So in the invertebrates, in the non-chordates, the north cord is ventral, not dorsal. What my point? In our case, in chordates, in vertebrates, in merudandi prani, in vertebrates, in chordates, not the vertebral column is present in dorsal side, so spinal cord is present dorsal side. In invertebrates, non-chordates, north cord is ventral. Ventral, understand? So, is the tail the ventral and double? It is present double. It is present like this, double and ventral side and solid. These are not hollow. In our case, the spinal cord is hollow. Yes? There is a space inside the cord. Okay, but here these are saline, and ganglionated. Here the ganglia are present. Maybe like this, and some they are connected. Here that means what? This is the cytoplasm, this is the axon. Cytoplasm, axon. Like this. The knot rod means it is the chain of knot cells. So a number of neurons or knot cells are present, but two knot cords. Okay, saline. No space within that cord. So that is knot cord is double ventral solid, not hollow. Solid. Ganglionated. This is a. And heart is, if it is present, then dorsal in position. Our heart is present in ventral position. In invertebrates, in not quadrates, if heart is present, it is present in the dorsal side usually. Okay, remember this point. And anus is present at the end of the tail. End of the tail. Suppose you see, this is the ascaris. Suppose this is ascaris. Ascaris around worm. Ascaris a nematoda. Suppose this is the tapering part, narrowing part, tapering part. Suppose this side is the head, because mouth is there. Mouth is here. And at the end of the tail, tapering part is called tail, actually not tail, but this at the end of the tail, anus is there. Anus. Okay. And respiration occurs through the body wall or through the structures, various structures. Through the body wall. So if the body wall, that is made up of two or three layers, ectoderm, endoderm, or ectomesoenderm. Okay, through the body wall, the exchange of gases occurs. Respiration, exchange of gases, oxygen and carbon dioxide. So exchange takes place through the body wall or through the structure, specialized structure called gills. In fish, gills. But I am not talking about the quadrants, non-quadrants or invertebrates. Gills, trachea. In insects, trachea. It is the tube-like structure, so the tubal system, tube. Okay, trachea, nori. The trachea system or gills, gallis. Okay, these are the different other structures, book long, that we will study. When we will study the arthropoda, we will study different type of respiratory organs in them. Arthropoda and mollusca in them, we will study. So, what we discussed in this session, we discussed the classification, outline classification of the animal, kingdom Animalia, and the characteristics of non-quadrata. Write out the short note on non-quadrata with all these points. Okay, thank you.